Here are the tasks you need to complete to load data from Oracle Human Capital Management Cloud into Oracle Cloud EPM Workforce Planning or Oracle Strategic Workforce Planning Cloud. First, in data integration, download the HCM extracts. These are metadata templates that include header records used when integrating data between HCM Cloud and Workforce Planning. In a local folder, save and then unzip the compressed file. Here are its contents. These files will be used as templates during the integration process. Next, in BI Publisher, import the eText template in the Shared Folders Custom folder. Here's the imported file. During the data load, this template converts the data into the required format. Next, in Oracle HCM Cloud, import extracts. Make sure to import all the extracted XML files. When importing files, leave the legislative data group list empty. Next, validate imported extract files. A green checkmark under the status column confirms that the extract definition compiled and validated successfully. Then, submit the extract file. Remember to validate and submit all extract files. In data integration, make sure you have period and category mappings defined. Then, configure an Oracle HCM Cloud connection. Name your connection, enter your Oracle HCM Cloud service URL, and user credentials. Next, register your Cloud EPM application, making sure to select the Workforce Input Cube. Specifying a prefix is optional. After you register the Workforce application, set target dimension classes. Next, initialize HCM data sources. This also initializes an integration based on your connection. Here are the initialized HCM data source applications. You can manually create these data sources. Make sure to upload and select the HCM extract file that contains the metadata you need. For example, for FTE data, associate the assignment data extract. If you manually created HCM data source applications, you'll also need to create a data integration. If you ran the initialization process, an integration is predefined for you. Edit the integration to make sure the integration options and mappings are defined based on what you need to import. When the integration was initialized, a location was created. Locations link the source, target, and import format. Locations allow you to set attributes that refine or filter the data you want to integrate. In this example, I'm setting the functional currency to no currency. In Map Dimensions, map the source dimension to the target dimension in the application. This information is stored in the import format. In this example, I'll be loading FTE data only, so I'll remove the other account driver selected in the source expression. Mapping members allow you to translate source values to valid members in each target dimension. If you did not define target expressions when mapping dimensions, you must add a mapping for each dimension. I'll also update mappings to load data only for a specific employee. Don't forget to save your changes. Set integration options for the target data load. Make sure the employee's effective date is valid. For target options, my integration requires that the load method is set to load all data types with security. I'll leave purge data file to no so I can review the loaded data per process ID. When finished, save and close the integration. I'll open a form and show you where to expect the data to change. After running the integration, the FTE assumption for this employee will be updated. Now I'll return to data integration and run the integration. Select an import and export mode, as well as a start and end period. Then click Run. When the integration process completes successfully, you can view the results in the workbench. Because I set a mapping to ignore employees and jobs that do not match my explicit criteria, rows noted with ignore will not be loaded to the target. I'll filter the data to show the employee data I want to import. Here's the employee data I set to be imported to the target. I'll open my form to verify that the data was updated. Data was imported. The FTE assumption for this employee and workforce is now set to 1. To learn more, visit docs.oracle.com.